Hello everyone. In this video, we will see about electrostatic type instruments. These are the some contents of this video, like working principle of electrostatic instruments, construction of electrostatic type instrument, then force and torque equation. And last one is about advantages and disadvantages of electrostatic type instrument. So first we will see working principle. As the name suggests, the electrostatic type instrument uses static electric field to produce the deflecting torque. These types of instrument are generally used for the measurement of high voltages, but in some cases they can be used in measuring the lower voltages and power of a given circuit. Now there are two possible ways in which the electrostatic force can act. Next point is construction of electrostatic type instrument. Here two possible conditions are there. The first condition, when one of the plate is fixed and other plate is free to move. Plates are oppositely charged in order to have attractive force between them. Now due to this attractive force, movable plate will move towards the stationary or fixed plate till the moving plate stored maximum electrostatic energy. And second thing is about, in this arrangement there may be force of attraction or force of repulsion, or both the forces, attraction as well as repulsion, due to some rotary of plate. Next point is force and torque equation of electrostatic type instrument. Now let us derive the force equation for linear electrostatic type instrument. This one is linear type electrostatic instrument, and right side figure, this is about rotary electrostatic type instrument. So first we will see about linear electrostatic type instrument. Let us consider two plates as shown in the figure. The plate A is positively charged. Plate A is positively charged, and plate B is negatively charged. As mentioned previously, the first condition is, we can see here, we have linear motion between the plates. The plate A is fixed and plate B is free to move. Let us assume there exists some force F between the two plates at equilibrium, when electrostatic force become equal to the spring force. This one, spring force. At this point, the electrostatic energy stored in the plates is half CV square. Now suppose we increase the applied voltage by an amount d phi due to this the plate B due to this plate B moves towards the plate A by a distance dx. By a distance dx, the work done against the spring force due to the displacement of the plate B is F into dx. The applied voltage is related to the current, and we can write for that I equals to C dV upon dt plus V dC upon dt. From this, the value of electric current, the input energy can be calculated as VI dt equals to V square DC plus CV dV. From this, we can calculate the change in the stored energy, and that comes out to be half V square DC plus CV dV. So this is the change in the stored energy. By neglecting the higher order terms that appears in the expression, now applying the principle of energy conservation, we have input energy to the system equal to the increase in the stored energy of the system plus mechanical work done by the system. So from this we can write V square DC plus CV dV equal to the half of V square DC plus CV dV plus F into dx. So here the input energy is written in this purple color, V square DC plus CV dV, and it is equal to the stored energy of the system, that is half V square DC plus CV dV, and the mechanical work done is F dx. The summation of both is equal to the input energy of the system. So from this equation, force can be calculated as F equals to half V square DC upon dx. So this is the equation for force, and this is for linear type electrostatic instrument. Now we will see the torque equation or force equation for force and torque equation for rotary electrostatic type instrument. We can see the diagram for the same. that is a rotary type electrostatic instrument. In order to find out the expression for deflecting torque in case of a rotary type electrostatic instrument, we have to modify the equation of force. We have seen for linear electrostatic instrument. Now we have to write the equation for deflecting torque, which is TD equals to half V square DC by DA. Now at steady state, we have controlling torque is given by the expression TC equals to K into A. The deflection A can be written as A equals to half V square DC upon K into DA. From this expression, we can conclude that the deflection of the pointer is directly proportional to the square of the voltage to be measured. Hence, the scale will be non-uniform. Now, let us discuss about the quadrant electrometer. This instrument is generally used in measuring the voltage ranging from 100 volt to the 20 kilovolt. Again, the deflecting torque obtained in the quadrant electrometer is directly proportional to the square of the applied voltage. The advantage of this is that this instrument can be used to measure both the AC and DC voltages. One advantage of using the electrostatic type instrument as voltmeters is that we can extend the range of voltage to be measured. Now there are two ways of extending the range of this instrument. We will discuss one by one. So first method is by using resistance potential dividers. The circuit diagram we can see in the figure. The configuration, circuit configuration, we can see the voltage which we want to measure is applied across the total resistance R, that is small r, complete resistance, and the electrostatic capacitor is connected across the portion of the total resistance which is marked as a R. Now suppose this one is the electrostatic capacitor. Now suppose the applied voltage is DC, then we should make one assumption that the connected capacitor is having infinite leakage resistance. In this case, the multiplying factor is given by the ratio of electrical resistance R upon R. The AC operation on this circuit can also be analyzed easily again in case of AC operation, we multiplying factor equal to the R upon R. So the second method is by using capacitor multiplier technique, we can increase the range of voltage to be measured by placing a series of capacitors as shown in the diagram. Let us derive the expression for multiplying factor for the circuit diagram. Let us mark capacitance of the voltmeter as a C1 and series capacitor as a C2. Okay, C1 is the capacitance of voltmeter. Now the series combination of these capacitor will be equal to the C equals to C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2. This is the series combination of the capacitor, which is the total capacitance of this circuit. Now the impedance of the voltmeter is equal to the Z1 equals to 1 upon j omega C1, and as total impedance will be equal to C1 plus C2 upon j omega C1 into C2. This is the total impedance of the circuit. Now multiplying factor can be defined as the ratio of Z upon Z1, which is equal to the 1 plus C2 upon C1. Similarly, the multiplying factor can also be calculated. Hence, by this way, we can increase the voltage range to be measured. Next point is advantages of electrostatic type instrument. Now let us look at some advantages of electrostatic type instrument. The first and the most important advantage is that we can measure both AC and DC voltage, and the reason is very obvious. The deflecting torque is directly proportional to the square of voltage. Next is the power consumption is quite low in this type of instrument, as the current drawn by this instrument is quite low. And last advantage is we can measure high value of voltage. Last point is about disadvantages of electrostatic type instrument. Instead of various advantages, electrostatic instruments have few disadvantages, and here it is given. These are quite costly as compared to the other instruments, and also these have large size, scale is not uniform, and Various operating forces involved are small in magnitude. These are the disadvantages. Thank you for watching this video.